Hello friends, welcome to Daring Mariner YouTube channel. Today we will be discussing about India's Deep Ocean Mission. What is Deep Ocean Mission and all? The Union Cabinet has approved the long pending Deep Ocean Mission, which among other things involves developing a submersible vehicle that will allow a crew to plunge 6,000 meters into ocean and hunt the floor for precious metals. Union Cabinet Minister Prakash Javadekar told reports that such technology and expertise is now available only with 5 countries, USA, Russia, France, Japan and China. India will now be the 6th country to have it, that is Deep Ocean Mission, submersible vehicles for plunging 6,000 meters deep into the ocean to hunt precious metal. In the work since 2018, the mission is expected to cost 4,077 crore over the next 5 years. The estimated cost for the first phase of the 3 years, 2021-24, would be 2,823.4 crore. The Ministry of Earth Sciences will be the nodal ministry implementing the multi-institutional mission. For more marine-related topics, do like, share, and subscribe to this YouTube channel, and hit the notification bell for instant updates. There are 6 components to the program. A manned submersible will be developed to carry 3 people to a depth of 6,000 meters into the ocean with a suite of scientific sensors and tools. An integrated mining system will be also developed for mining polymetallic nodules at those depths in the central Indian Ocean. Polymetallic nodules, are also known as manganese nodules, are potato-shaped, largely porous nodules found in the abundance carpeting seafloor of world oceans in deep seas. Besides manganese and iron, they contain nickel, copper, cobalt, lead, etc., which are of economic and strategic importance. In other, these are the polymetallic nodules can be seen at the depths of deep sea, on the base of seabed and all. The exploration studies of minerals will pave for the commercial exploitation in near the future, as and when commercial exploitation code is evolved by International Seabed Authority and United Nations Organization. Understanding climate variables. The second component involves developing ocean climate change advisory services, which entails developing a suite of observation and models to understand and prove future projections of important climate variables on season to decade time scales. The next component in searching for deep sea flora and fauna, including microbes, and studying the phase of sustainability utilizing them. Yeah, we have not yet been properly utilize or have research about the flora and fauna in the deep sea oceans of the Indian Ocean. So it will be helping much for the India's deep sea ocean mission. The fourth component is to explore and identify potential sources of hydrothermal minerals that are sources of precious metals found from the earth crust along the Indian Ocean bed or oceanic ridges. The hydrothermal mineral deposits are accumulations of valuable minerals which formed from hot waters circulating in earth crust through fractures. They eventually create rich metallic fluids concentrated in selected volumes of rock. So, in the deep Indian Ocean bed organic oceanic ridges, we can see that hot water circulating in the earth crust through some fractures, so they will be rich in rich metallic fluids and all, in the form of concentrated volume of rocks and all. The fifth component involves studying and preparing detailed engineering design for offshore thermal engineering conservation, energy conservations, OTEC, power desalination plant. So there will be desalination plant for water filtration and all, distillation process, fractional distillation process, or desalination process, for developing more in the field of that and preparing detailed engineering design, ocean thermal energy conservation. The final component is aimed at grooming experts in the field of ocean biology and engineering. This component aimed to translate research into industrial application and product development through a on-site business incubator facilities. India has been allotted a site of 75,000 square kilometer in Central Indian Ocean Basin, that is CIOP, by the UN International Seabed Authority for exploration of polymetallic nodules, that is PMN. These are rocks scattered on the seabed containing iron, manganese, nickel and cobalt. Being able to lay hands on a fraction of that reserve can meet the energy requirement of India for the next 100 years, say officials at the Earth Science Ministry. It has been estimated that 380 million metric tons of polymetallic nodules are available at the bottom of seas in the central Indian Ocean itself. So it is a huge amount, 380 million metric tons of polymetallic nodules. For more marine related topics, do like, share and subscribe, and hit the notification bell for instant updates. Thank you.